Kids, sometimes in life you see someone and you just instantly know. This is the person for you. It can happen anywhere, even the waiting room of a tattoo removal clinic. And that's what happened when I met Stella.
Doctor, are you all right? I heard a woman screaming in here. Oh. Sir, please don't yell at me. Because when people yell at me, I have a tendency to start crying. Please don't do it. Abby, wait, I've told you before, when they're rude to you, hang up the phone. Go on, you can do this. Hang up. Abby, hang it up. I'm sorry. I just wish that some patients would be nicer to you.
Hi. Here. I stopped. Hi, I stopped for coffee and I thought I'd grab you something.
Oh, wow, thank you. That's so nice. You're like a knight. I should call you Sir Ted.
What?
Nothing. Dr. Zimmerman, Ted's here. Thanks, Abby.
And?
Hi, Ted. I'll let her know.
Telepathically?
That's funny. That's funny, smart, and great. Ted, I found your book.
What?
Your book, The Power of Me. I think you accidentally dropped it in the garbage.
What? No, that's not mine. I've never seen that book before.
No, you were reading it in the lobby.
What? No, you have me confused with someone else.
No, look, right here, from the personal library of Ted Mosby. That's you. Ted, sure, what's it regarding?
I just want to see her. I want to look at her. See what she looks like.
I don't understand.
I'm sorry, did I accidentally oprima numero dos when I called?
Do you speak English? I want to see her!
Sir, please don't yell at me. Because when people yell at me, I have a tendency to start crying. Please don't do it. Please. Oh, Abby, did my hypnotherapist call yet? No. Oh, hi, Ted. Love the stash. You look like a young Tom Selleck, only a million times handsomer. Dr. Zimmerman, Magnum's here to see you. Just kidding. Stupid. All my friends told me Abby be strong. He doesn't deserve another chance,
No.
I forgive you!
No!
He seemed so nice, but then he just kept toying with my emotions.
Wow. This Ted guy sounds like a real jerk. You know your problem? You're too sweet.
Aren't you going to see the doctor about that mole?
Oh, yeah. Turns out it's just a raisinette. Hey, how would you like me to take you out to a fancy restaurant and then go on a shopping spree? Treat you the way you should be treated. Would that make you forget about that Ted monster?
My mom's wrong. There are nice guys in New York.
We just have to go by my hotel room first. My bed was broken. I just have to make sure they fixed it.
Then if it's fixed, can we have sex on it and then go shopping?
I like you.
Abby.
Why are you trying to ruin my life?
Well, you slept with me and then you never called me again.
And?
That's it.
That's it? As far as I'm concerned, if I leave you safe on dry land with adequate transportation home, you got nothing to complain about.
Well, it hurt, okay? And then Ted, the love of my life, started dating my boss instead of me. Do you know how that feels?
Oh, boo-hoo. Poor little Ashley.
Abby!
A few weeks ago, Ted dumped me as his wingman. You had a crush on him for a couple weeks. I was Ted's best friend for 7 years.
Ted said Marshall was his
best friend. 7 years!
Sorry.
Ted, what an idiot. With his stupid, meaningful relationship with Stella.
Ted. I hate Ted.
I hate Ted more.
Are you as turned on as I am?
Probably not quite as much.
I'm sorry I yelled out Ted.
I'm sorry I yelled out Abby.
I am Abby.
Oh, cool.
You know what I hate most about Ted?
What?
His stupid hair. His stupid, lame, awesome hair. It's so stupid and awesome.
You know what I hate most about Ted?
What?
How he's always like, oh, I want to fall in love and have a relationship. I care about the people I have sex with. He's so lame.
He's so lame and awesome.
You know what he needs? He needs to see just how horrible he is when he's in a relationship.
Yeah, and I need to show Ted that I'm over him. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I think so.
You're thinking of having sex with Ted?
Hey, Ted, fancy bumping into you here. Have you guys met my girlfriend, Abby?
Yeah. Hi, hello. Abby. So you guys are dating now?
That's right. I am done with this whole being awesome thing. Now I'm all about farmers markets and day hikes and matching khaki cargo shorts. Isn't that right, sweetie?
That's right. Girlfriends are lame. Unless they're me. I miss you, Ted.
Abby and I are in love. Not hot, passionate love. Couple love. You know, movie night with my girlfriend. Then waiting for her to go to bed so I can steal one pitiful moment of hollow ecstasy by the cold blue light of my computer monitor.
We're showing Ted how lame he is.
You don't have to say it, though.
Okay, Barney. You can stop.
Stop what, Ted? Stop being in love? Next, he'll ask us to stop breathing.
We can't stop breathing, Ted. Your hair looks amazing.
Barney, I see what you're doing. Please stop.
Not before I share with you what being in a relationship leads to, Ted. Abby, Pookie Bear, I am so pathetically desperate for you that, heck, I'll just say it. Will you marry me?
Wait, really?
I would never joke about true love.
Yes, I'll marry you!
Okay! Thank you.
I have to call my mom. It finally happened, Mama. I just wish Daddy were alive to walk me down the aisle.
Champagne for everyone. On me, the happiest guy in the world.
Ginger ale, it's a bit.
Hey, I think I left my tie here. Have you seen it?
No. I'm in wedding planning mode. Stressville, population me. Okay, big decision. What do you think the cake should be? Budgie the Whale or Cookie Puss?
Yeah, that was a bit. We were doing a bit.
So I'm thinking Labor Day. I was gonna say 4th of July, but I didn't want to steal any attention away from America.
Abby, I've got some bad news. I can't marry you.
What?
Ted begged me not to. I think he's in love with you.
Really?
Yes, our plan worked. Better than we ever dreamed. You have to go to him. Here's his home address. But you know what? He works late, so I wouldn't go before 2 or 3 in the morning.
Oh, my God, thank you. But now I feel wrong keeping this.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't worry about that. That's made of candy. Later.